Terry Harmon, along with Pro Wrestling personality and expert, Steve Ricker.
In this program of World Pro Wrestling from the Pacific, it's final time for the TV belt. Tony Rickard of New Zealand versus Larry O'Day of Australia. Now, last week, these two knocked out of the competition, Samoa's Tamatata and New Zealand's Merv Fortune. So first up tonight, we're going to bring these two together to decide third place. Right, deciding third place then, Merv Fortune of New Zealand against Tamatata of Samoa. Both these two, you know, in some ways, Steve, unlucky not to make it to the final.
Well, yes, they put up tremendous matches, Barry, and any one of them would have deserved going through to the finals. And we have Merv Fortune now with a Fortune with an armlock applied and Tamatata counting, but Fortune follows through with another counter. And comes out. Nice tip up there, Tamatata. Tamatata looking for a hip toss. Of course, he goes behind here properly. No, he's missed it. I was about to say he could have taken a normal stick in that position.
He wasn't quite at the same speed as what Tony had to counteract that weight.
No, of course, they are both probably very evenly matched as far as weight concerned, Barry, because I would say that Tamatata and Merv Fortune both weigh in at approximately 7 stone.
Good scissors.
Scissors on Merv Fortune.
Mm-hmm. Fortune looking for a toehold counter.
He's got his head out and he's going to get the hair out.
There's a toehold applied. Fortune. Tamatata trying to reach through to claim the head of Fortune to ease the pressure and break his hold.
It's a very tempting for any opponent of Merv Fortune to grab that hair. You certainly get a good handful. Well, these two really locked at the moment.
Just coming in coming with a forward headlock. Try a forward headlock.
Look, Rebel, when this could be one of the first to, probably the first to challenge for the television belt and challenge against Larry O'Day or Tony Rickard. Whoever wins tonight in the final for the television belt.
Tamatata with the pressure applied, Fortune backing Tamatata into the rope. The knee up in the stomach, and another one. As we try and move Fortune to break. Breaks the move and throws the head of Merv Fortune into the corner. Turnbuckle. Fortune comes out for the hard one.
The hard one really bounced off that one.
Ooh, a heavy body slam. On the start of those
three. He drops
and Fortune moves out from under.
Well, an awkward fall for Tamatata.
And immediately Merv Fortune, the
smart wrestler that he is, working on that leg.
Just goes in behind us after to drag the leg back up over his right shoulder.
Well, I think Tamatata will feel one like that.
Fortune again coming over behind him, applying pressure.
Now you can just feel that one ripping away at the back of the leg of Tamatata, Steve.
Yes, you can see the steps on the thigh muscles there, Barry, with the pressure of Fortune's applying. Talking Fortune. Referee just checking for a submission. Watch for refereeing by Jack Kendall again. On the ropes. Referee calls for a break. Headlock applied. Hammerlock. Hammerlock. Once again, he locked in. Yes, there's that simple but effective hammerlock again. Forcing with that hammerlock on. Not much action in this match. To suggest these two pretty evenly matched, please. Yes, they must be. There's a match of strength here, and neither rest are giving anything away, of course, but compared with the all the matches of the tournament, this match would be the slowest of the matches. We've certainly seen a passing through this tournament through the finals, and of course this here is the find the third place getter, and Mir Foote with that side headlock now applying pressure.
I think that neither one really wants to use up any excess energy.
Japanese arm twist. Out of two only.
I'm going to go on for Tom Mustafa. I think he just might have it. Oh!
Wow, that's a nice one by hit toss by Tom Mustafa.
What this time?
Japanese stomach throws.
That will be.
Count of two, and no. Hold on, the Fortune has taken it. Count of three. And the match goes to Mir Fortune. And this.
Now, decision time for the Stevie Belt. Well, Steve, it's your boy up against that wild
Tony Lennon from Australia,
Larry Adele. Well, Barry, I don't know about Tony, but I have the butterflies myself. I know when he comes up against O'Day, he's coming up against a big beaver. O'Day is strong, he's tough, he's got the weight, and he's got years of experience behind him.
Just in the back of your mind must be that encounter between O'Day and Ricky Rickard.
Well, that's something I'll never forget, because then Ricky received the broken leg, and that was in the match with Larry O'Day. Of course, with Tony, if he wrestles the way that Ricky used to wrestle these matches, he'll do the right thing. He'll hit and run. He'll get in there because he's giving away a lot of weight, and he's giving away a lot of experience. But he does have youth and speed and wrestling ability.
All right, make a prediction.
Well, that's a hard one for me.
Make a prediction.
As I say, the man's got a lot of experience on him, and not clear for this to come out.
Well, my pick is Tony. I've just got a feeling about Tony, I really have. So, in the ring, Larry O'Day of Australia, a man who's fought the world's best, and Tony Rickard with youth and speed.
This is the one we've waited these few weeks for, Steve. Larry O'Day and Tony Rickard. O'Day won the cup against Tony. Well, I guess this is the one that will prove it all. Barry, this was Tony. A lot of faith in him. He's fast, he's a little rougher. But Larry O'Day is a tough customer.
Well, as I said last week, Steve, I think it's self-reward that Tony has got this far. Got himself to the finals. One of the fine reasons he's come up with this year.
Well, as you say, it's self-reward getting here. And let's hope he can carry it off. He's wrestled the match the right way. He's thinking. And he's not moving in and getting caught. He's counter wrestling, and this may be the way to wrestle this match against Larry O'Day. Larry O'Day was full Nelson applied.
Well, we'll see if your prediction is true, Steve. It comes true in the match.
Another counter and a full Nelson.
Whatever, I think we're going to see a beauty here. Whoever wins this television bout will certainly know he's been in a very tense and close match.
Better leaning over.
each had two matches, each won two matches to get into the final.
And here we are still with the Phil Nelson applause.
Nice work, Larry O'Day.
The attorney, he's got to use his wits here and try to outthink O'Day and concentrate on his counters and his wrestling ability. Crowd calling for Tony. Hits into the pod. No, O'Day comes back. Once again, takes the arm. Or hold on the arm of Tony.
Now the crowd calling for Tony. He's certainly the crowd's favourite.
Move away.
He won't get it easy from the Wild Australian, Larry O'Day.
He's showing it first. No,
for the other match to steal. That's the way he's got to do it. Just the unrelenting, just keep at Larry O'Day.
Right, he's got to keep at him. He's got to keep away from him also, David. Larry O'Day is no doubt about it. He's tough, he's rugged, he's strong, and he's heavy. And the way for Tony to wrestle this match would be to hit and run. That's just about what it comes down to. He's not getting too close, but there's no doubt about O'Day. He is also a very, very strong man.
Well, as we see here, as he endeavours to get out of this hold of Tony Rickard.
He's going to try and keep O'Day off his feet.
O'Day is crossing.
Heavy shoulder crack. Good moving. Nice moving. Now stay in there, Tony. Hold on. Ducking the blows. And as I said before, hit and run. And that is the way to wrestle this man.
Well, he's not giving O'Day any room.
Arm stretch.
Twists himself around. Get out of the arm stretch. Referee Jack Kendall down on his stomach now to check this one.
O'Day coming to his feet.
See some of the experience of O'Day here, Steve.
Yes, the years of his training time. But Tony's still in there, forcing him back to his shoulders.
Tony Rickard,
known to his fans as PR, and he's really right in there now, and trying for all his work to take the television belt.
What can O'Day do this time? Oh, back again.
Lean back, more pressure applied to the armpit. Larry O'Day realizing he's in trouble.
Well, he's just a hair's breadth away from getting yourself free there, but back he goes now for the more pressure from Tony Rickard. Another twist for that face. A boot on the ear.
Day trying to stretch out and reach that rope. The referee counting, applies the count.
Well, Tony Rickard will be pleased with himself at this stage. A little way to go, I would think. And we're looking for the fall. There's the bell again.
The prize, the winner of this match will receive the television wrestling trophy. Knee drop into the back or the arm of Larry O'Day. Larry Rickard stretches out, head to head now to gain more pressure for Hemlock. Nice bar in his Hemlock. Big knee by O'Day. And another one. Tony goes down. Heavy forearm. Tony in trouble. Day on top now, and Tony in a dangerous position. Get up on your feet, Tony. Don't stay there.
Wow, the dangerous position. And O'Day's mad. He's thrust him into the cat.
Well, this is the danger point in this match, Barry. With O'Day comes up on top, he gets those heavy whacks in, and now he's driving the boots into the chest of Tony. Tony across the second rope. Referee applies the count.
Getting plenty of room to move now, Steve.
Is that a cut again? Heavy forearm. Heavy on the right. Heavy elbow by Larry O'Day, and Tony hits the canvas. O'Day looking for a cover, looking for a fall. Count of two.
O'Day looking confident.
The final gets near the end. The side suplex by O'Day. Throws off, brings it knee up. Count of two, almost a fall. So he's trying to fight his way over. Matching his strength with O'Day. This could be a little dangerous for him. O'Day is very, very strong, and O'Day comes back.
Final for the television belt. Anyone's yet. Larry O'Day and Tony Rickard.
Heavy one to the stomach, another one to the shoulders. O'Day applies the body to them. O'Day now with the pressure applied and the referee asking Tony if he wants to give up.
No, says Tony Rickard. No way. We're going for the television belt. Heavy one, heavy fist to the chest.
O'Day still with that body scissors applied. Drain the strength from Tony with the pressure he's applied to his stomach, and also dragging his head back.
Well, you can see, and you can hear the pressure that was being applied to Tony there. Larry O'Day mouthing away to Tony Rickard.
Obviously telling him to give up, but knowing Tony, he'll fight all the way to stay in this match. And now comes up over across O'Day. O'Day still with the body to applied. Heavy forearm. A good one. Good one. Now Tony should move away from him.
And get up.
Out of the body sitting. Move back, Tony. O'Day drives right back in there. Tony really in trouble.
Well, is Tony slowing down?
He's taking a lot of punishment
in
these last few minutes of this match. Today, he's got all his weight and all his strength.
Let's not write him off yet. He put up a good fight.
He certainly has put up a good fight there, and I really hope he comes right back into it. He's trying hard and trying to drag his legs out from under O'Day. Going backward. Heavy forearm. Come on, Tony, get to your feet. Head and run, Tony. Flying out. And the body suit applied again. Day with the body.
Well, he's really wearing Tony Rickard down now. There it is, the trophy they're fighting for, the television wrestling trophy.
Again, when he's trying to fight his way clear of the body. Driving the forearm into the chest of O'Day. Tony on his feet. Day knocks his legs out from under him. Lean back. Come on, Tony. Keep it on him now. Knee lift.
Well, I think Tony's powering a little. He's using every ounce of energy now on this last night. Beautiful.
Good, beautiful back drop. Whoa, knee drop by Tony. Tony back into this match. Near the spot. Maybe knee across the chest and a foot across the chest.
Count.
Now the two only. So far, Barry.
Third count.
And he runs him through the shoulder. Takes it there by the arm, drags him out of the corner, into the opposite corner. Up the climb, oh! Over the top rope, he wants to climb up, he's down, he's up on the ring, he's on the floor.
I think he hit his head heavily there. For the leg.
The referee applied a count. Tony coming to his feet.
Oh, sorry, way for it to happen. Well, it looks as though he might have hit one of the legs there as well. Oh.
The winner, Larry O'Day, but what a disappointment.
Well, it's coming over here. What a Tony Rickard, you got it.
Thank you very much indeed. Yes, and when you see that replay, you can almost cast your mind back to 5 years, 3 years ago, where his brother went out of the ring the same way. Only he didn't walk out. So it's been Dad, Ricky, and now the dummy hit the duck.
How do you feel after that one?
Terrific. I think everybody out there realized at the start that I was going to win it, and all the way through I looked as though I was in control, but I got to say one thing for the kid. He hung on for a fair while, which is more than I can say for a lot of other people.
Yeah, he hung on well. Well, now you've got the television belt, are you going to take on all comers?
Anyone who wants to get in there with me is...